This video contains subject matter that may be offensive and disturbing to some people. If you are the type to require a warning throughout a video or show, let this message serve as your warning. This channel discusses the harsh reality of true crime. If this warning is not sufficient for you, consider a different genre and unsubscribe from my channel immediately. Oh, look how dark it is. Hold on, gotta fix that now too. Jesus, what isn't working here? Or what is working? Hello. And welcome to the show. Just a second. Gotta fix this now. Yeah, look at that, huh? Now it works. Yes, hit that like button. Yeah. Got the number up on the screen there for you guys. You guys want to call in and you can talk about whatever the hell you want to talk about. That's what we're doing. Hey, thanks, Juju Positive. There's the fist pump. Oh. Well, thanks for making sure it worked. Yep, doubleheader tonight. Thanks, in the middle of nowhere, bear. Yeah. Yeah, so the number, I think the number on the top of the screen is working, so you guys can call and talk about whatever the hell you want to talk about, or we could just, you know, people wanted me to come back on, so here I am. And I would feel
just
weird not coming
sure
on.
Super chat works. Okay, it's good. Ansikte som blinker med ögonen.
Here, let me try to. I'm gonna change that. See if I can do it on the fly. I haven't tried that before. Let's see if we can change the voice on the fly here. So that's the
double header.
It was supposed to show up right in there. Didn't seem like it was. All right, let me see. So if I test the super chat. Oh yeah, it shows up there. That's just a test one you can send in. All right. Text to speech.
This is our test.
I have it set to Swedish.
let me
switch it to, let me try something else. How about Emma, British voice. See what that sounds like. All right. Hey, somebody called in. All right, 304, you're on. Hello, 304, you can unmute yourself. Hello.
You there? I don't know why they're not answering. 304, you need to unmute yourself.
Oh, you don't mute? That's you? That's what I thought. I don't know. There should be something where you hit a mute button. You unmute yourself. Because I'm clicking on something that says ask to unmute.
Thank you, whoever in the chat said star six. That's what's up.
Well, doesn't it tell you to do that or something? Or
if it did, I missed it. I don't know.
Oh, I've never done
I
it.
I forgot.
So. I would know.
Yeah, it's pretty annoying. It used to be sweet. You could just unmute me.
Well, you are now. Well, you're on the show now.
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Wait, this is a show?
Yeah, you're...
I called into a show? I thought... I'm just joking.
Yeah.
How's it going?
Yeah, not too bad.
Yeah.
Just chilling out.
What's that?
I was about ready to do a deep dive into Morphew and Chris Watts, but...
Hell yeah. I was actually calling in because I wanted to talk about Anadarko oil.
That's what I was thinking.
And there's a certain podcast that loves to just talk about the same couple things over and over, and they're diving back into Chris Watts. It's terrible and it makes me cringe.
Oh yeah.
No, I was like super ill, so like I missed like shows. Anyway, I don't know if you covered this, but did you hear this craziness about the Salt Life guy? Did you cover that? Did you see anything about it?
The which one?
You know how you see a bunch of, excuse the terms, and I'm sorry if anybody gets offended by this, but you know how you see a bunch of douchebags with Salt Life stickers on the back of their car?
No, I haven't seen that.
It's like a super cool beach thing.
Here, hold on one second.
They're only super.
You can tell. I gotta hold on.
What? I heard blue. So I guess I'm hosting the show for a moment. How's everybody doing tonight? That's good. Glad to hear it.
Chris got stuck out. She couldn't get inside the door with the key.
Ah, that's so, not good.
So you got to run the show for a little bit.
Yeah. I just said hi and oh god, I'm having flashbacks. It's like nom for me.
I'll be Chewbacca if you want me to.
It's awesome. Hey, what were you telling me about?
There's this brand called like Salt Life. There's probably a million people in the chat that are like, oh, this is old news, but whatever. It's like a big brand and they sell like surf garbage and like they have like restaurants and stuff. And like the dude that created it just like murdered somebody and went on the run, and the cops actually did a great job of apprehending him. If no one else is calling in and you wanna, I can give you his name if you wanna look it up.
Okay, when was it?
Just like, I don't know, a couple days ago.
Okay, what's his name?
So, Michael, like Hutto, Hutto. I don't know, but he's like 55. He's like this 55-year-old drug-addled maniac that was dating like an 18-year-old and like went crazy. I don't know. But I think it sullies the brand Salt Life, and everyone should probably peel that off their car now.
So he said he was having a play gunfight, but then he forgot to take the bullets out or something, or what?
Yeah, I forgot about that. Yeah, he said some craziness like that. But, yeah, I don't know. I heard, like, just a tiny little bit of it, and there's people, like, defending him, and there's people, like, demonizing him. And I figured, like, might as well bring it up to Gray to, like, let him look at it and tell me what he thinks.
But, I mean, is there some kind of conspiracy around it or something? Or?
I don't think so. I think he was just a drug-addled maniac that cashed out on some gigantic brand that he helped create.
Mm-hmm.
And like it was created in Jacksonville, Florida. And a rule of thumb for me is never trust or like anything that comes out of Jacksonville, Florida, because it's a terrible place. And yeah.
Good advice. Everybody that was once a member of my channel from Jacksonville has left, but thanks.
They can stay. You're defending well, yeah. them. I'm the bad guy here.
I think there are a lot of serial killers.
My car got stolen.
Yeah. Oh, it did? What do you mean?
Well, in Jacksonville, like 2 years ago.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. I went out to get a veggie burger out of my car and was like, oh, my car's gone. And, yeah, they never found it. I think that bums probably sleep in it somewhere in the woods.
Beyond meat, huh?
Yeah. This is pre-beyond meat. This is pre-laboratory vegetarianism.
Like exactly. Don't you think it's weird? Here's the weird thing about this beyond meat stuff, right? Listen to this.
Oh, here we go.
No, listen to this for a minute. Listen to this. You're actually eating meat, okay? It's not like it's
not really
soy.
Meat.
It's not soy or something like that. It's actually like lab made meat. Yeah, that's weird.
I don't think so. I mean, it's made in a lab, but I don't think it's actual like tissue from.
No, but it yeah, right. It wasn't from an animal, but it was. It's like grown
it's
to
good.
Something. So it's, you know, yeah.
It's weird that. It is considered plant-based, but it's weird that, like, when I order one at, like, a decent restaurant, I have to say well done because it bleeds. Like,
see?
There's actually, like, fake blood in it.
Right. See, there's something a little off about that one. Listen, I would rather get I'd take a vaccine over eating one of those again. Actually, it tasted pretty good, though, I'll admit, right?
Vaccines. What's going on with that vaccine? Is anything happening with it? Because, like...
Oh, we need to get it out there. Like, supposedly, of course, you know what they said? Oh, yeah, Trump had nothing to do with it. It was, you know, like they would have made it that quick anyway. You know what I mean? The whole thing was because everybody was trying to make it really quick, right? And then they get the government buys it from them. But then there's all these other ones that are putting out the vaccine, too. But theirs was 90%+, which is amazing for a vaccine. It's usually 50, yeah, you know, 70% maybe. 50 to 70.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
I heard that vaccines have aluminum in them, and they're going to make you nearsighted. I heard that the vaccine will make you nearsighted. Nobody should take it.
I don't agree. I think it's.
I'm just joking. I just made that up.
Okay, yeah, that's made up. Watch, there'll be a little thing below my video. Vaccines are safe.
Oh God, yeah,
despite
you're probably
what,
right.
Yeah. Yeah. Well, what it is see the
aluminum.
Listen, the aluminum actually that they're putting in that has nanotechnology that allows the government to track all of us after we get injected. It's amazing.
I knew DARPA had something to do with the vaccine. I knew it.
Yeah.
I've been saying it all along.
Yeah.
But I did hear that if you wrap your body in aluminum foil prior to getting the vaccine, it will just like stop the transmitters in all the nanoparticles. That's what I heard.
Oh, that's clever. That's clever. Yeah. So everybody listen to me. Right before you get your vaccine. Don't do recreational mummification. I mean, do it, but this time use tinfoil, okay? So go in there. The only thing that's open is maybe make a little tiny circle for your arm where the shot might go in, and then have a couple holes for your eyes and maybe one for your mouth so you don't end up like the guy in the story that we told. You need to be able to breathe.
On the Halloween show, I legit was wearing like the OG Nefarious shirt.
Uh-huh.
And I wore it to my girl's house the next day because, you know, I'm a sucker and I had to stop there before I actually went to work. And I was in the kitchen and she looked at the back and was like, what the hell does your shirt say about a librarian?
Oh, yeah, that one? Oh, yeah, that's right. I forgot. That was a good one. The quote was something like, don't leave a... what was it again? Something about pencil?
I can't remember.
Oh, God.
It was the funniest shit ever, though. I love it.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, because it was like the guy, it was in the, that one case. What was the one? What was her name? Shit. It was the case where it was out and she was jogging with the Fitbit on. I can't remember her name. Tibbetts, right? Molly Tibbetts.
Yeah,
right?
Molly Tibbetts.
Yeah, so she was running around and then the... what was it? So when the guy killed her, he said he looked down and saw some headphones, and then he realized that that must mean there's, a dead jogger in my car, in my trunk. So then I said, yeah. So if you look down and you see a pencil, assume you have a dead librarian in the back in your trunk, something like that, right? I don't remember if that was the exact quote, but...
It was amazing, and that's like my favorite part of the shirt. Like, of course, I like the nefarious guy peeking through the brick wall, but like the librarian quote, that's the icing on the cake right there.
Yeah, because I forgot about this.
I will. I'll hang up if you want to like look at the Salt Life case. If you don't, whatever.
Yeah, I've got it on the screen.
Somebody more productive should call in. And I'll be off and I'll listen.
Yeah.
And you can. I haven't had time to like.
There was a guy that used to come, used to be on the channel, and he used to write down all my quotes. But I don't know where that person is anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah, and he had a big list of them.
Bet you I know what happened to him.
What?
He went insane from writing down all your quotes.
Probably. I wouldn't doubt it. Wouldn't doubt it at all.
You got the best quotes on YouTube. I'm just kidding.
Oh, yeah.
Chewbacca?
Okay, try to do it. Try to do it right now. Let's try to do it. Here we go. Here, let me... I'm going to be... I'll be... You just have to do your part. Okay, here we go.
Just a second.
Chewbacca.
I'll be Chewbacca if you want me to be. Hold on, let's do it again. Do it again.
Right. Chewbacca?
I'll be Chewbacca if you want me to be.
There you go.
Full disclosure, I believe that lady was a prostitute. And believe she was trying to lure me to a different parking lot.
Yeah, I wouldn't disagree.
no, thank you.
Hey, listen, she was going to be Chewbacca if you wanted her to be, okay? If that could get a few bucks in her pocket is what she was trying to tell you. But...
reminds me of I think it was in The Devil's Rejects, that Rob Zombie movie, if anybody knows about the android and Star Wars quote in that movie. Probably not, but that's a good movie.
Those aren't the droids you're looking for.
Well, no, it was about a prostitute being space themed. Anyway, it was a good movie, and I am so awkward. I will let you go.
You are awkward, man. Sorry, it's always good having you call in.
And derailing. What?
It's always fun having you on.
Why? Because I derail your freaking show.
You never know what you're gonna get.
So
man.
Hard.
It's like a box of chocolates.
I don't even know what I'm going to say.
Yeah.
Like, I always look back like, why did I just say that? Anyway.
Yeah. That's all right, though.
I was doing paperwork. I may or may not have had one or two Stillweather Spirits gins with the cucumber.
Oh, yeah?
And that's some good gin, man.
I didn't even get to try that one. Gin. So it was pretty good, huh?
Yeah. I mean, I like the original. The original is super good. It's one of my favorites, but like, it's nice to have that little hint of cucumber in there. It switches it up. Like, I couldn't drink it all day every day.
Yeah.
But like, I mean, I couldn't drink anything all day every day. I'd never get any work done.
Well, thanks for qualifying that. For a minute, everybody's like, wow. he would drink it all day every day.
Towers and falls.
He would drink that all day. Every day, if it didn't just have the little cucumber taste in there. It's amazing. Yeah.
All right. Well, I will stop derailing. I'm going to jump off here and hopefully somebody more productive. There we go.
Oh, God. Saved by the bell. All right.
I heard a ding. All right. Later, dude.
All right. Have a good one. Thanks for calling. I don't know what this is, but the 290123, I guess. Yeah, I can hear you. Who's this? What do you mean? It's a true crime channel normally, but we just had a random caller. Yeah. Yeah, I'm just trying to figure out why you're, it sounds like you didn't even know what you were calling about. So all of a sudden now you're switching it. Huh? Well, no, I told you it was after you said, what am I calling? You asked me what you were calling about. Okay. Have you called in here before? Okay. Well, what was your question?
Right. Mm-hmm. So, like, I'm just confused. Like, how did he get there? Because, because like he's a suspected figure.
Yeah, I don't know. And, yeah, I mean, I don't really do conspiracy shows.
Oh, but. Sorry. So okay, but then maybe I can ask you because he. Like applying true crime to that avenue. How exactly does that happen? Sorry if you could just.
Well, I think you're talking about Epstein, how he died in the.
In the cell, right? Like it's.
Yeah, I mean, it seems really suspicious because you'd have cameras on him. You'd have they should have been looking at him. He's a huge witness in a huge case, and the cameras, I guess, weren't even on or something. Right then, the guards weren't around. And then all of a sudden, boom, he's dead. And there's a lot of people out there that are definitely wouldn't want him to say what he would have known.
Right, of course.
Yeah. So it just seems, you know, it doesn't seem like, and then that second autopsy didn't, you know, help matters very much. So it just sort of feels like, you know, who knows if it's a conspiracy or not.
Right. So whether it's a conspiracy or not isn't as important. But like how, like, obviously you're very experienced with true crime. So how exactly would you go about that? Like not like how you'd kill someone, but like generally, what type of patterns do we see with like political assassination, which I guess, and stuff? Or is that not your field?
Well, I mean, I don't really cover that stuff because that's kind of in the conspiracy realm. But it, you know, I would say that most of the time it happens when the person being killed knew something about stuff that would be really damaging. That's what my answer to that would be.
Okay, sure. I guess that makes a lot of sense, actually. Okay. Thank you. Sorry, I couldn't have proposed a more interesting conversation.
Well, it's not bad. Anyways, I appreciate you calling in. Thank you.
Uh-huh. Thank you. Bye.
I don't know what if that guy was. What I think he was. I think he sounds kind of normal because he didn't say anything. I just wasn't sure the whole time because he was asking some strange things, but we get so many weirdos that call in, especially on Saturdays, that you just never know, right? I don't even know what his name was. Yeah. So let me the thing that the case that just a second. Hold on 1 second, I gotta go say hello to the wife really fast. Okay, the case that Cairo was talking about. Oh, really? Epstein's still alive? Oh, wow, that's amazing. Is he in one of the vats of oil over at Anadarko. Okay, so here we go with the... This is the story that Cairo was just talking about. Salt Life co-founder was having play gun fight and deadly shooting, he tells cops. Hey, where's Zozo? She was going to call in. At a hotel on Singer Island. Let's see where that is. Okay. So I got... That's way down in Florida, I guess, right there. Things went terribly wrong when the co-founder of the popular clothing brand Salt Life said he held up a gun in the middle of a play gunfight and shot his girlfriend. A police report released Monday states, Michael Hutto, 54, was no longer is affiliated with the clothing company, told police that he and Laura Grace Duncan, 18, is that his girlfriend? His girlfriend's 18 and he's 54. I don't know. Told police that he and Laura Grace Duncan, 18, were planning to drive to the Keys when they decided to stop midway and go to the beach, police said. They checked into the Hilton Hotel. He said they were pretending to shoot each other using with their fingers. Kapow! Kapow! They would say. I'm just kidding. It doesn't say that. In the hotel room, or in the Philippines, they say, Kachung. Kachung! Kachung! It's like, why would that be something that's international? Just, it should be the same, right? Okay, he said they were pretending to shoot each other using with their fingers in the hotel room, and that as his girlfriend sat on the bathroom counter, he picked up his real gun, and it went off. It said boom! All right. Without calling for help, Hutto drove off in a Dodge Challenger Hellcat, grabbing his backpack and leaving behind his wallet and cell phone at the hotel, his arrest report says. He made it as far as St. Augustine before running out of gas, according to his arrest report. So first they were shooting each other with fake, you know, the finger shooting. And he just grabbed his gun and it went off and shot her right in the head. You know? Uh-huh. That sounds really possible, you know? Very legitimate. Without calling for help, Hutto drove off in a Dodge Challenger Hellcat, grabbing his backpack, but leaving behind his wallet and cell phone. So he just got the hell out of there. But he probably didn't want to be traced, so he left his cell phone there. He made it as far as St. Augustine before running out of gas. Hutto is from Welburn, Florida, which is about 75 miles west of Jacksonville. Duncan lived in neighboring Lake City. In Hutto's arrest report, police say Duncan's father referred to Hutto as his daughter's boyfriend. That's, I mean, 18 and 54. I mean, that's a, that takes sugar daddy to a whole nother level there. No, his first mistake was shooting the girl in the head, Gene. You know, on purpose. It wasn't an accident. But yeah, his first mistake, perhaps in the cover-up of it, sure. He was arraigned in Palm Beach County Monday morning. Bond was set at $255,000, which he can easily come up with. That's kind of a low amount. Duncan's body was found October 29th in the Hilton Hotel. She suffered a single gunshot to the stomach, so it wasn't to the head. She had been dead a day. Duncan's father, that's the most painful way, too. Duncan's father asked police to go to the hotel, concerned that he had not been able to reach his daughter for days. He said they last spoke several days earlier. Well, I mean, how come the maids didn't go in and clean it? Like, I mean, it shouldn't have been where she was discovered a long time later. Let's see. Duncan's father asked people to go to the hotel, concerned that he had not been able to reach his daughter for days. He said when they last spoke several days earlier, his daughter seemed out of sorts. Burton Duncan told police he thought his daughter's boyfriend, Hutto, was giving his daughter drugs, police reports state. Duncan told police he tracked her cell phone to the Hilton Hotel. Surveillance video shows Hutto leaving the hotel in a green and black Dodge. Could have put the sign out that says, you know, no service or something. Police across the street were told to look out for Hutto and his car. That's when police in North Florida contacted Riviera Beach police to say the man they were looking for had been hospitalized in Jacksonville after a possible overdose. Court records say police were called to BP gas station in St. Augustine for Hutto after Hutto entered it saying he needed help on October 28th. Records say Hutto seemed delusional and his eyes were rolling. What was the 29th up here? Oh, her body was found on October 29th in the Hilton Hotel. But what's weird, I mean, the part that is weird is that they didn't find her just by doing their daily, you know, service to the rooms. Court records say police called the BP gas station in St. Augustine. And so October 28th is when he needed help. So he had already left, so she was probably killed way before that. Law enforcement officers went to the hospital to speak with Hutto. He blurted out, "I think I may have hurt my Gracie." When they asked if he knew why they were there, police said. On October 30th, Hutton was led from the hospital in handcuffs. He was wearing blue medical scrubs. Hutto, who sold his share of the clothing company several years ago, had been previously arrested in Jacksonville area, accused of putting on a pair of shorts and a shirt over his own clothing and attempting to walk out of the store before being caught. He just sounds like a crazy, like something's wrong with that guy. I mean, he's got all kinds of money. Why would he need to steal anything? Just so he can. Life was boring, so... No, he said they were going kapow. Jeez. Yeah, let's see. On Friday, October 29th, Detective Morgan Crisma and Saunders responded back to Baptist Hospital, Jacksonville, Florida, where they made contact with Mr. Hutto. Mr. Hutto was reread his Miranda rights by detectives. Mr. Hutto stated him and Gracie was headed to Florida Keys to visit some of his friends. They stayed at the Hilton. Detective Morgan asked Mr. Hutto to explain what took place at the hotel. Mr. Hutto stated that him and Gracie spent time on the beach. Just a second. Mr. Hutto also stated that him and Gracie was playing inside of the hotel room, and if they were shooting with their finger and a gun. Mr. Hutto went on to state as Gracie was sitting on the counter inside the bathroom. Anyways, hold on. Let me get this. I gotta drink some liquid here. Oh, you guys couldn't hear anything, right? A second ago. Sorry about that. I'll play that again in just a minute. All right, 1738. Hello, who's this?
I'm an anonymous fan.
Oh yeah? Okay.
What's going on? Yeah, I have kind of an interesting take on Casey Anthony.
Oh yeah?
Yeah, I kind of believe like in a time where we're really battling for the reproductive rights of women, I do believe that Casey Anthony was extremely justified in what she did.
Oh, yeah. Well, I think that's ludicrous.
Why is that?
Because it just is. What was your you said that it was justified that she killed her because of what? What was the main reason?
Well, because I personally believe that abortion should be legal after around 8 years after conception.
Oh, I know you don't actually believe that. You have to be a total moron to believe that. So
no,
you're
not
just being sarcastic, right?
No, I'm not being sarcastic. I promise. I'm actually in a women's studies program, I'm very educated on this topic.
Well, you sound like a total moron then. I mean, here's the thing is if you're educated on the topic and anybody taught you anything like that, then they should be put in prison too.
No, no one taught me that. I've learned all these ideals by myself and through studies.
Well, that's unfortunate. Do you do drugs often or?
No, I don't do drugs.
Oh, okay.
I believe that women should have the right to abort children up to 12 years in emergency situations, such as if the babies may be a little bit stupid or a little bit annoying.
I mean, you don't actually think all this, right?
8 years should be in most situations, but
no. But why do you think? I mean, you're obviously just like you're trolling, being sarcastic.
No, I'm not trolling. I promise.
Well, I know you are. Okay.
No, I'm not trolling.
Because even your name, you know, Casey Anthony 1738. I mean, come on.
Because I like Casey Anthony, and I think what she did was right, and she's honestly a feminist. Like icon.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, she's an icon, yep.
She's a feminist icon. Honestly, she paved the way for reproductive issues or for reproductive rights amongst women.
Oh. Okay.
And I think I don't understand why no one else is talking about this because Casey Anthony is truly like honestly so inspirational.
Man, everybody, we've got comedy night in here. Yoo!
It's not comedy.
Here, let me get the
I don't think women's reproductive rights are funny, and I don't really understand.
Well, I think what's funny, what's idiotic, you'd have to be joking to be saying what you're saying. So that part's funny. I don't think comment that reproductive rights were funny. I made a comment that you'd have to be a total idiot to be saying what you're saying. So therefore, I'm assuming you're playing around. So I think that's funny. I never once mentioned that reproductive rights. See, you're the classic idiot. When you get stuck in an argument, you bring out something that somebody didn't even talk about. I didn't say anything about. I wasn't laughing at reproductive rights.
You as a man should have no place into saying when Casey Anthony was justified in having her abortion. She decided to have her abortion around, what was it, 5 years after her pregnancy? That is totally justified. What's the difference between a one-month abortion versus a five-year abortion? Absolutely nothing.
See, I think what you're trying to make is the point. You're trying to do like a reverse argument saying, yeah, what is the difference, right? So why should you be able to have an abortion at all? That's what you're trying to do, is do the reverse psychology argument.
No, I'm not using reverse psychology. Yeah. I believe that women should have the right to abort their child whenever they deem
necessary. Basically, women, in your mind, should just be gods, and they should be able to control who gets to live and die.
Casey Anthony is my god.
Okay. I'm going to have to get you off of here now, because I know you don't really believe that, but you just sound like an idiot.
Thank you for your time.
Oh, what a total idiot. See, but the scary part is actually some, I think that was a fake collar person. They were trying to be sort of sarcastic about it. She should be able to have an abortion up to 12 years. Because what difference does it make? You know? It's really lame, because you sound like a total whack job. Oh, jeez. It sounded like who? It didn't sound like Casey Anthony at all. That's just people wanting it to sound like her. It doesn't sound like Casey Anthony whatsoever. Well, they're kind of funny, but I don't want to waste my time, you know. You know, what do you get out of a conversation like that? Especially when it's not real. Like, I don't believe that person legitimately believed what she just said. So I'm not going to sit there and waste my time trying to do a logical conversation with somebody that's starting off from a joke position. I mean, it's just stupid, you know. Hang up tip. Thank you. I don't know what that means. Oh, hang up tip. You're giving me a tip for hanging up. All right, thanks. You know, I've had discussions on here about abortion before, because on this channel we can talk about all kinds of stuff like that.
Thank you.
Yeah. And we've had conversations, hypothetical situations, just to sort of see what the differences are, and we've had those many times. And, you know, they're interesting. Makes people think. Thanks, Kevin Brown. Believe it or not, though, that is one of the things that is argued sometimes on far left. It's called postpartum abortion. You know, like after birth, there's actually some people that have argued that up to maybe a year that they should be able to still abort their child because it's theirs. Okay, here's the one that, here it was.
Led to the arrest of Salt Life co-founder Michael Hutto. Court documents show Hutto told investigators he and the girl were playing with a gun before she was found dead at a Palm Beach hotel. Hutto faced a judge for the first time since the teen's death. Here's On Your Side's David Jones with what happened.
A due to find a defendant based on the four corners of the probable cause affidavit is in fact a flight risk.
54-year-old Hutto was slapped with a $255,000 bond on a charge of manslaughter and an additional $5,000 on his weapons offense charge.
No weapons, no firearms, no contact with the family of the decedent.
Tonight, the probable cause affidavit revealing Hutto was reportedly dating 18-year-old Lake City teen Laura Grace Duncan at the time of her death at a hotel in Riviera Beach. Investigators say Duncan's father was aware of the relationship and told them he hadn't had contact with his daughter
Cairo,
for days
Kevin
before
Brown,
she was found dead
Christy
with a gunshot
B.
wound inside a room at the hotel. Investigators say he told them he thought Hutto was, quote, giving her drugs to keep her sedated. The day before Duncan's body was found, Hutto reportedly overdosed at a St. Johns County gas station. Detectives from South Florida who questioned Hutto at the hospital in Jacksonville say he told them, quote, oh my God, I think I hurt my Gracie, before crying. According to the affidavit, Hutto said he and the teen were heading to the Florida Keys to visit friends, that they stopped at the hotel and at one point were, quote, playing inside of the hotel room as if they were shooting with their finger and a gun. He said at one point, quote, he pointed the gun at Gracie, it went off and shot her, police say. Manslaughter carries a maximum sentence of 15 years in Florida, but Hutto's charges could be upped if new evidence comes to light. David Jones, First Coast News, on your side.
What a pile of crap that guy is. Yes. Hey! Thanks, Tanya Rowe. So, that's that story. Pretty crazy one there. Yeah, if you want to join the channel, go ahead and do so. We won't be entertaining the questions about these wild phone calls. I don't know how to do those, you know, because I didn't feel like that was a serious call right off the get-go, you know. I hope I wasn't too mean, though. You know?
Gray, you were so mean. Can't people just have different opinions?
No. They can't, Mary Lou. Okay? That's not something that there's an opinion on.
Yeah. I don't know. I thought it was just really... here's the thing, is I was sort of stuck in this weird limbo mode because I figured that she was being really sarcastic and sort of this crazy dry humor type thing where it was sort of going so far overboard, like she almost like she's an absolute pro-life person who was throwing out this crazy scenario so that people go, yeah, and then you start thinking, okay, well, when is it okay? And then you go all the way back, you know. So that's kind of what I thought she was. So then I wasn't sure how to act on it. If I knew for sure that she was serious, then I probably would have been a little bit more, you know, not pleasant. You know what I'm talking about. Yeah, I could do my my scenario again for you guys since the topic was brought up, just to see what if anybody new that's listening, you know, might listen to it and go, yeah, that's weird. Yeah, well, the problem is what didn't really work is that if she was joking, she should have said, okay, you're right, I was just being, you know. But she never did. She just kept going until the end. You know what I'm talking about, Jen. Oh, God. Now it's a different name calling in. Oh, God. What are all these different... Oh, how come there's two people here? Hold on. Oh, that's the same one from before. That person's name was Sharon, by the way. Let me... Okay, Truth... Yeah, you're in. Yeah. Yep, I can. What's going on? Pretty good. Yeah, you sound a lot like that caller from earlier. You don't seem like you've ever even watched the channel before, but then you're calling in. You did a what? Okay. Yeah, we're talking about crime, whatnot.
Have you ever covered the murder of Seth Rich?
I don't know. Sort of, it sounds familiar. Wasn't that kind of a bigger case or something?
It wasn't as big as it should have been. So basically, it was a guy that was heavily involved with the Hillary Clinton campaign.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
And he had some very, very concerning evidence that he was tweeting everywhere saying, I'm going to release this, going to release that. And then, for some reason, he ended up being killed in a botched robbery, as the police called it.
Yeah, but the last caller that sort of, like you, called in, and he was calling in about Epstein. So it seems like you guys are like hanging out together or something. What? I mean, it's weird that two people in a row call on for political, you know, murders like that.
Well, I mean, he's probably right. have you looked up the Epstein stuff?
No, I've seen it.
I didn't see that part. I just started watching, but
I think it's kind of you know, the Epstein thing seems suspicious for sure. You know, especially all the stuff he knew.
The Seth Rich stuff is also pretty suspicious, man.
I mean, I think almost, I don't know if you ever seen the, if you go onto YouTube and watch the, you should look for it, it's called the Clinton Chronicles.
I've seen that.
It's VHS.
Don't you worry about that. I've seen that one.
Yeah. That one's pretty crazy. A lot of people just sort of, like in your, you know, when you're about 45 years old, nobody really knows 50 people that have died, you know?
Yeah, it's very true.
And then all of a sudden, they know.
Suspicious murders, yeah.
Yeah, so that's kind of weird to have that many people around you dying, and you're not even that old when that was going on.
So true.
Yeah. So.
So yeah, I just want to discuss that one. Talk about the Seth Rich murders. You know. Make sure you're unbiased. You know what I mean? A lot of these people that cover this stuff, so much bias goes into it. They got some hidden agenda. Some people are paying them. You know what I mean? Stuff like that.
Yeah, well, my show isn't really, I don't really do these kind of topics like Seth Rich, you know, I don't do things that can be considered like political conspiracy, true crime. I do more like cold cases, missing persons, things like that.
Right, fair enough.
So, I mean, what was it that you wanted to say about that?
I just think, you know, if you really get deep into that, those kind of conspiracy theories and stuff like that, I don't really think it's fair to even call them conspiracy theories, if you ask me. But there's always a couple of people that seem to be at the end of every single one, if you know what I mean. You know what I'm talking about, Mather?
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about, bro.
Yeah, well, it is kind of, it is interesting. Same people.
It is very interesting.
Yeah.
Same people, bro.
But I've seen him. But I've seen the, you know, I mean, you always, like, I'll watch a video here and there on those types of things just because I want to watch it. But I don't take them and go, oh, wow, this is the absolute truth. Because you never get to actually know. It's sort of like.
But guess what? Some people watch CNN and they do the same thing. They say, oh, this is the absolute truth.
Well, that's true. That is true, right?
The farthest thing from it.
But see, I try not to do that because when I watch CNN, I know that literally almost every. It's just a complete propaganda station that put out false information for five years minimum, even longer than that, but 5 years completely had one goal. And that was to get rid of Trump as president. They absolutely, that was their goal.
Exactly.
So that's 100%. There's no doubt about it in my mind. I've said it on the show. It was just really obvious. And I think they know that. And what's scary is that it had a huge effect on the minds of a lot of people who didn't seek out any opposing view of it. So like I do is I watch all the channels, CNN, MSNBC, Fox News, ABC, all the, you know, everything. And then you can just tell where the bullshit is because there's only a few channels that play every single thing that Trump said from start to finish. And when you watch it, it's so different than the edited chunks that they would play on CNN. Like they'll just play one part and go, see, look at that. You know, and then everybody goes, holy crap, you know, so.
It's crazy.
Yeah.
The issue is there is no opposition voice, you know.
Well, that's the scary part. And now Fox News is even sort of kind of. So after that, you're looking at something where you have one voice for one party and the hell. But I think it's going to have a huge negative backlash because there's a lot of people that realize that. I mean,
it's true.
You know, the thing in this last election, the number one, the most votes ever gotten was Trump, but then he was beat by Biden. So it's like. You know, in the entire history, Trump got the most votes as well of any election ever, but then Biden beat him too. And that just seems kind of odd, but, you know, the sad part is if the election was real, you know, all the votes, let's just pretend that every vote was perfect and everything. That entire side voted against Trump. I don't think there's more than 1% of the people who voted for Biden are like, yeah, man, I can't wait to have him in there.
Oh, you know, for sure.
Like they're excited for him. They can't wait to get him in there, but they weren't excited for him. Like, he's such a great guy. Everybody prior to this all thought he was creepy Joe, you know, a total creepy, you know, guy putting his hands on girls all the time. He is somebody that plagiarized people. He lied to the media. There's all kinds of stuff out there. And then all of a sudden he's awesome, man. He's great because he's not Trump, you know. And that's a sucky reason to vote, you know. So
yeah, it completely is. I mean, like, I do think there is a sizable portion that voted for him because he's a communist, but I just think that, like, personally, you have to, the really, really hard issue about this stuff is that you can't have a opposition because they don't have the money. You know, if they don't have the money to start their own truth center, as I like to call it, they're not going to be able to fight off against the fake news. Because the fake news have infinite amount of money. And you know where they're getting it from?
George Soros.
Yeah, they're one of them, you know. Yeah. Israel's another one.
Well, I don't know about that, but... I mean, I think, like, George Soros is...
That's a cold case right there. Where's the money coming from? Should start covering that.
My thing is, I mean, during this election, I talk politics sometimes, but it's not my main... you know, it's not even close, really. I just cover actual crime, cold cases, not political stuff like that. But, anyways. Well, cool. Thanks for calling in. I got to get these other...
No problem. Gas the Kikes.
I knew it. God, I was always thinking he was going to say something right at the end. God. I almost cut him off at the right time, but it didn't work. Yeah. God. Sorry about that, everybody. I was kind of thinking that right at the end, I would be able to... I was just turning the dial. Ah, God. Yep. Okay. Yeah, see? What do you mean you didn't hear him? Well, I knew I could... The whole time I'm sitting there going, oh, God. So that's why I kept trying to talk the most. I'm not sure why this other... How come you're still there, Sharon? Are you still there? Why are you still on here?
Hey.
Yeah, but I thought we were done. You called a few minutes ago, right?
I'm not. First, I'd just like to say God bless.
Huh? I can't hear you.
First off, I would love to say just God bless our current president of the United States, Donald J. Trump. And that is why I would like to briefly share on my thoughts on Diane Downs, because I believe her case...
Oh, God. Oh, Jesus. Okay. Man, this is turning into some crazy crap right now. Right? Here we go, everybody. Make sure to send in the super chats of support, because here we go. Oh, God. Oh. What did who say? He said something. He said to gas the... And then a reference to Jewish people. Okay? He's a psycho. Yeah. All right, 801, you're on. 801, you have to hit like *6 or something to unmute yourself. Huh? Who is it?
Stormy Ray.
Oh, Stormy Ray. Okay. How's it going?
Yeah, it's going all right.
Yeah.
Got some interesting callers calling in tonight.
Oh, yeah, they're just whack jobs, you know?
I'm so sorry. You deal with it so well, though.
I should have got the hint once he said that Israel's funding the channel. That's when I was like, okay, you gotta go. And then he snuck in his agenda comment right at the end.
He did. He stuck it right in there.
Darn it. Sorry about that.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry, Gray. You shouldn't have to put up with that. The work that you do is amazing. And, you know, all of us freaks.
He hopes they're calling from a padded room.
Oh, somebody just said, well, thank you. I appreciate it. Let me turn this up. There we go. Oh, she said, I hope they're calling from a padded room. Okay. And thanks, Shogun Love. All right. All right. Go ahead.
I was wondering, did you ever, I know I had mentioned it a long time ago, but last November, so it's been a year ago, around the 20th, between the 20th and the 30th of last November, in Tooele, Utah, there was a woman, an elderly woman, who was found dead in her home, and she was in her bed. So they thought, okay, well, she passed away of natural causes, whatnot. And they go in and they start to see if they can figure out why she died and when was the last time she was shopping by looking at things in her fridge or her freezer. And so they open up her freezer and they find her husband's dead body frozen in her freezer. And I've tried to find other information on this case because I'm kind of curious about that. I mean, why would this old lady have her husband's body in her freezer? And she's found dead in her bed. It just didn't sit well with me.
Wait, say that part again there. I was trying to, I got the, there's some weird caller waiting. Go ahead, say that last part again.
Okay, no.
About the freezer.
It just didn't, it didn't sit right with me that they found this older woman dead in her bed, and then they found her husband dead in the freezer. And I've looked and tried to find information on the case because, like I said, it was last November.
Well, what did they say was the, what would they say the cause was? What'd they say? Murder, suicide, or anything?
No, originally they said that she must have died of natural causes, and then they found her husband in the freezer. And then they decided that they were needed to do some investigating, and they've never released anything else that I can find on that. So well, I was wondering if possibly...
I mean, didn't they find him in the freezer right away, or did it take them a while to find him in the freezer?
Yeah, it was pretty, like, the next... It was within the 24 hours they found
her. And so that was their cue at that point? Well, maybe we should look into this a little bit.
Yeah, maybe we should find out why this husband is frozen dead in the freezer and she's dead in her bed, you know?
Yeah, I think that... because the only scenario that would make sense... if it was murder-suicide, would be something like the wife killed him. I mean, it would be really weird to have him kill her and then he goes into the freezer. How was she killed?
Yeah.
How was she killed, you know?
Exactly.
You know?
Exactly.
Yeah, that doesn't make a lot of sense.
Like, I was wondering, well, did he die and she couldn't afford to bury him? And so she put him in the freezer just to wait to pass away herself, hoping that maybe somebody would bury them together. I thought, well, you know, trying to reason it through so that it's not something horrible. But, you know, it just kind of looks like that's not the case, but...
Well, you should see if you can, you can't find anything on that at all. You should send it to me.
I can't. Yeah, I don't have the resources that you do, the new stuff that you can go through. I don't know how you find the news articles that you find.
When was this?
It was November, I think it was November 24th, right around November 24th of last year, 2019.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
That seems like a weird one. Let me just see if it's in Utah, you said?
It was, Tooele. It's T-O-O-L-E. Spelled funny.
Yeah. Well, it's just Utah. That's all they, you know. Let's see.
Well, Utah.
2019. You said November.
Yeah, it was between the
two. Oh, look at this. Here it is right here. I found it. Look at it. A man who. Yeah, it says a man whose body was in a freezer for as long as 11 years. Oh my God.
Yeah.
Was the husband of a woman who had recently died in their apartment. So now it's a little different because it's like she had him in there and was probably trying to keep him from, you know, I don't know, somebody just typed in VP up there about trying to collect Social Security. That kind of makes sense.
Mm.
Let me just read this quick, though.
She didn't want 11
years was the husband of the woman who had recently died in their apartment. But the autopsy that nailed down his identity didn't help investigators solve how he died, who killed him, or exactly how long his body was tucked into the chest freezer inside the couple's apartment. Officers discovered the body of Paul Edwards Mathers, 69, last Friday, after finding his wife dead on the bed when they went there to check on her after she hadn't been seen in 2 weeks. Detectives couldn't tell from looking at the fully intact body how he died, but suspect foul play. Hansen said the death of his wife, Jean Soren Mather, 75, is not considered suspicious. So maybe she killed him, but then somehow was able to get him in the freezer, although that'd be tough for,
tough for
know,
her age, right?
Well, at the time, though, 11 years prior.
Because she was in there for 11 years. But if she was six, almost 70.
Well, no, she would have been. Well, she'd been 64 at the time. I mean, that's still pretty old, 64. But I don't know how big he was. If he was like a smaller guy, like 5'4", thin, you know, she could easily do that. But if he was a big guy, that'd be tough. You know, she may have had some help too.
Yeah.
Well, there you go. True. It was actually in there.
I have wondered about this case and wondered and wondered and wondered, and I just can't find anything else on it. It's just like, okay. I mean, did she not want to deal with the funeral? She couldn't pay for his funeral. There's no cause of death for him ever released. And maybe she just wanted, you know, to keep him near her some way. I don't know.
Well, somebody mentioned above that it's a perfect way to keep collecting Social Security because it looks like he's alive, you know. And well, at the time though, how old he was? 60. The weird part about it is the article has him at 69, but that might have been how old he was when he died 11 years ago, right? He doesn't keep aging then.
I wonder if that's what it was.
Yeah, he was 69.
I don't know.
So if you add that 11 if you add 11 to that, he'd be 80, and she's 75, and that's a little bit more kind of reasonable right there. And that's about, now he's 69, so he gets full Social Security benefits, and then he's dead, and then for 11 years, she got all of his, and she got all of hers. So she was making out like a bandit. Mm-hmm.
Not really.
Yeah, it's not a lot of money on Social Security.
Well, it depends.
Yeah, like if you have the maximum Social Security, you can get some kind of money. Yeah, it's not terrible.
Yeah, I kind of got put in a bad spot myself, so it sucks. But I was a nurse, and then I was hit by an uninsured drunk driver.
Oh, jeez.
And yeah, he was uninsured, and the truck I was driving had 25,000 underinsured and 25,000 uninsured, so that only equals 50,000.
Well, send me an email with your. I'll send you the free cart mug since you were a nurse. I'll send you.
Oh, and no, I don't feel like that's right because I'm not on the front lines now. That was
yeah, but you would have been. You would have been. Okay, come on.
Oh, I would love to be. I would love to be, but I'm not.
Well, I don't. Well, I know that you're not now, but I think that you know, you got hit. You would have been on there, except you were hit by a uninsured drunk driver. So there you go.
I'm kind of scared about what Biden's saying about building bridges.
Mm-hmm.
I think he needs to take it really slow, because I agree with building bridges, but if he just all of a sudden decides to say, okay, all the illegal aliens that are in America now are now eligible citizens, and they're eligible for all of the government aid and all that, health insurance and everything like that, okay, then that is going to take a huge chunk away from the actual American citizens that have been born here, or the ones who came here legally.
That's always been something that really, it should bother a lot of people, but it doesn't seem to bother a lot of people. Really, it's really stupid. It's like, everybody...
It bothers me when I'm stuck on only $783 a month because dude hit me and there's nothing I can do about it because I'm crippled for life. You know, it's like...
Yeah. And why can't you have free this and free that? Instead, it's always the... Well, I know, but let's say health care. Let's say, you know, if there is money to be given out for people, health care, instead of just sort of giving it to, you know, people that aren't citizens, why wouldn't you give it to American citizens first? So, you know, because they were here, you know, it just makes sense, right? But it doesn't make sense to people.
I could have a surgery that could fix my back and possibly put me back to work, but Medicaid won't pay for it because they claim it's cosmetic.
Oh, really? Jeez.
Which is so stupid. Because
what's the surgery? To, like, fix a disc or something?
They'd have to go in through my stomach and fix the torn muscles there, and then go in through my back and fix the bulging disc there. I've already got, like, my...
That's crazy.
FI joints are screwed into my spine on both sides. There's two long screws there. But,
well, how is that cosmetic? Can't you get a doctor to say, hey, it's not cosmetic?
Yeah, I can. And then I have to go to the Disability Law Center and have an attorney represent me and take Medicaid to court in order for that to work.
Yeah.
And that's not going to work until COVID-19 is no longer... Utah's hospitals are max capacity right now.
Hmm.
So... And I just barely found out that I could do that because there's actually three doctors that are willing to, like, write letters and be like, dude, this could very well possibly put her back to work. And it would help her regardless, even if it didn't put her back to work, her chronic pain wouldn't be so bad.
Yeah.
But I would have to, I get those letters from the doctors, and then I have to take those and give them to the Disability Law Center, and then they take Medicaid support for me. So there's that, you know. It's just, I don't like to complain. I feel like I have gained a lot of knowledge and wisdom from being in this situation. I'm not complaining at all. Please don't think I'm complaining. I'm in a great situation because I have a roof over my head. I have my 10-year-old daughter. And we're good, and we are self-sufficient, and we don't need to go beg on the corner to canned outs or whatnot. And we make it by just by the skin of our teeth, but we make it. It's just, I feel like I've gained so much knowledge that I would never have known had I not ever had the near-death experiences and gone through all of the trauma and pain. That actually would have made me a much, much better nurse.
Maybe they can get you fixed and you can go back.
I would love it. I would love it so much.
I mean, that's one of the main things that people, like, you want to get people off of, you know, welfare. You know, people that, there's a lot of people that get, there's a lot of people that get welfare that actually don't need it, you know, like their health, you know.
Yes.
So if you can get them a skill, they can get out there and not only are they employed and they pay taxes now, they're a net positive. Like, you're, if you're on welfare and stuff like that, You're literally just taking money.
You don't feel good about yourself either.
Yeah, that's the thing.
When it's getting handed to you and you don't go out and work and you don't earn it. And the thing is that people think, I've been told these many, many years, oh, you're faking it, you're faking it. Well, obviously, the doctors don't think I'm faking it, and neither does SSI. But, you know, the thing is they don't realize how lucky they freaking are that they get to get up every morning and go to work and have a trade and have a skill and have a life and have people to talk to. It's like, I want to scream at everybody that complains about going to work, because I want to go to work. I really want to go help people. I want to do something. I want to feel like I'm contributing, not like I'm a lesser person because I'm in the situation I'm in, because I am no less of a person than anybody else out there. I have the biggest heart ever, and I take the shirt off my back and give it to anybody who needed it. That's just how I have always been. And I want to be out there. I want to be out there helping people. I don't want to be sitting here in pain with migraines and all this other fibromyalgia crap going on. And it sucks because everybody just complains, I have to go to work, and then like going, you don't know how lucky you are.
Yeah, well, maybe if you get go get that attorney and get the ball rolling, even if you have to wait. At least you'll get the ball rolling, and once the COVID crap's over, you can go right in there.
The thing that I need to do is go see Dr. House to have him write the letter. And right now I'm too afraid because he's at IMC Hospital, which is one of the biggest hospitals in my area. Mm-hmm. And I don't want to go into the hospital because of the COVID. It's like,
no, they got it. No, I've been into like four or five hospitals, you know, just with this neck thing, and it's really safe. I mean, everybody.
I know. How are you doing? How are you doing?
Well, I'm doing pretty good. Yeah, I mean, I don't know. I just started doing therapy 2 days ago, or yesterday, actually. Yeah. When you go in there, you have a mask on, and everybody's kind of socially distanced in there, and it works pretty good. Yeah.
Yeah. I get kind of sick of these people who refuse to wear masks and blah, blah, blah.
Yeah, masks work. I don't know how that ever became political, is what I say. I don't really understand how it became that way, but
good night,
it did.
Kvinna som räcker upp handen.
Thanks, VP.
Yeah. Your freaks are so awesome.
Yeah. So,
but yeah, I really appreciate too when you had your brother on, and we were talking, or was it your dad, your brother?
Well, my brother came on, yeah.
About the COVID, yeah. I really appreciated that because that really put a lot of my fears and my daughter's fears a lot less than what they were at. Really wanted to also thank you for that one, because that was an awesome show. If your listeners out there haven't heard that one, they should try to look it up and see if they can find it.
Yeah, it was
you and your brother talking.
Basically, everything
he
was saying was it's the same as it is right now. It was really interesting what he was saying.
Yeah, but he was right on the nose. And like I asked a couple questions in chat that he answered, you know, like with fibromyalgia, and like my daughter has, I have an older daughter who has Crohn's disease. They're autoimmune conditions.
Yeah,
I have two of them, and it's like fibromyalgia is brought on by an extreme trauma to your body, which 85 miles an hour, I think that would cause it.
Yeah,
I denied it for years.
Well, he's a rheumatologist, so they do all that.
Yeah, wow. Oh, I wish I could go see one. But he was amazing for doing that and answering those questions for me and the other people that were down in chat asking questions and stuff. So I just really wanted to say, thank you, Gray, because you're the only one out there that's doing what you're doing. You're following up on cold cases. You're donating money. You don't even take any of this money that Super Chats or people are donating to you.
I do. I mean, that's what I say every time. It's like when people send it in, some of it goes to supporting my channel, but a huge chunk goes to, you know, because I got to take, you know, I got, you know.
A huge chunk.
Yeah, I mean, we've put $18,000. So a lot of, a portion goes to me, of course, right? You know, but it's like if you donate, you know.
That's doing the work, too.
Yeah, I mean,
you're
I spend
all this work, and you should get some. You should get maybe even a little bit more.
Well, it'd be cool if there was actually ad revenue, but there isn't any.
Hey, all you booms, quit hitting on me. Could be. I'm
gonna seen a couple commercials, rewatching videos that I've missed lives of. And I'm like, what? He better be getting paid for that.
Yeah, yeah. No, it's cool. I mean, it's sort of a double.
I'll be sending him a check.
Yeah, I mean, when people send money in, at least you know that a big chunk of it goes to charity at the end of the month. So that's one of the.
Well, it certainly does. Hi, Cairo. I haven't seen Cairo for a while. But yeah, I mean, that nobody else is doing that. Nobody else I have found out there is honest like you and not speculative and not like making things more than it is. Like the marching band and the side of the trees
the
and Delphi that I mentioned.
Yeah.
You keep things real.
Hold on,
one of the year's best. Everyone
salacious.
Should watch it next.
Yeah. Kyra's...
Nobody...
Yeah.
Nobody goes over these cold cases that are all forgotten. But you do. And you'll go state by state and you'll say, hey, let's look at this state today and let's look up some cold cases and let's get the word out and see if we can... jog any memories. And
yeah, it's something. It's you know, a, you know, at least it's, I'm trying to put it out there. It's, you know, it's pretty, you know, the odds of somebody seeing it and going, oh, yay, that's the one, you know, it's pretty low, but I try to at least put it out there so that it's findable or something that somebody might jog the memory of the right person.
One?
Yeah, go ahead.
I'll share one thing that I learned from since I've been watching your channel for the last like 2 years now. Because of one of the programs I watched, and I can't remember exactly which one it was, something about a woman was getting abused and she was basically kind of held hostage. It was a Stockholm syndrome type situation. And you had read an article and it actually had pointed out the signs of it. And I had realized that, the neighbor that lived in the apartment, Kitty Corner Family, had mentioned to me several times she wanted to come into my apartment and visit with me, but I could not tell her husband that she talked to me. And then she had a little girl that was in junior high, and I had a little girl in junior high at the same time. And my little girl talked to her little girl, and then her little girl went home and said something to her dad. Then her dad's pounding on my door, yelling at me, because her daughter talked to my daughter, or his daughter talked to my daughter, and that was inappropriate. And I'm like going, oh my gosh. And after a little while, I realized what was going on. That woman was being held, and she had Stockholm syndrome, and that baby was his baby.
Great.
And
you
she had no way out.
Investigates is the best.
Wow. So he was just one of those controlling types, right?
Yeah, yeah. She had no way out, and so I was actually able to get her out and away from him because of one of your shows that pointed out the sign, and that just clicked with me. I was like, oh my gosh, this is what is happening to this lady right here.
Well, how did she get out?
And she came to my house, and then I called some friends that I took her over to their house, and they kept her hidden for a while. And yeah, he came and knocked on my door and said, if I seen her. And I said, no, I have no, like, ever since you yelled at me last time, I haven't even seen your daughter or your wife. Mm. So sorry.
Do you know how it turned out? Like what happened later?
Yeah, I know where she's at. She and her daughter are safe.
Oh, cool.
And that's all I'm going to say.
Oh, good.
That's all I'm going to share because I know she's safe. I know her daughter's safe. I know they're happy. And, you know, it's because your show, because I learned that. I learned the signs from watching that one show of yours. And,
heck, I don't even remember the episode, but I know we talked about it many times. But
yeah, it's just amazing. I was like, okay, you got to get out of your house and come to my house, and then I will drive you somewhere safe. So I took her to somewhere safe, to another person's house that, you know, couldn't really be linked back to me, but we know each other. And you know, it was just kind of like a field of women helping women down the road, and she's set up and safe now with her daughter. So.
Well, good. Awesome.
It's amazing, but, you know, you did that.
Well, I appreciate you calling in with, you know, and I hope you, I mean, if you send me your address, I'll send you the free cart mug, though. Because you could have been a nurse. You should have been one still.
Yeah. Oh, I wish I was. I wish I was. I still, you know what, though? You know what's so funny? Is I would have to go clear back through nursing school because everything I did when I was a nurse was charting on paper charts. And everything's computerized now. And I think really the only paper charting they do computer charting and paper charting after a surgery and they're watching somebody.
Mm-hmm.
And then there's the rare doctor that still does the paper charting. But most of the hospitals and everything, it's all done by computers and machines. And I'd have to go back to school and learn how to do all of it.
Well, I'm sure
I could still do the IVs and catheters and medications and stuff. But like the computerized part of it is all different. All different.
Yeah, I think I can just kind of teach you there, though. I mean, you know, it's not like it's this big, high intensive. I don't think it would be that hard to learn.
It probably wouldn't. I'm not licensed anymore, of course, because, you know, I'm not going to keep paying for the licensing and all that. But it is what it is. And if I can do it, I sure do. I sure do want to. But the other thing I've been thinking about doing is just kind of starting up a YouTube channel with my daughter because she wants to become a YouTuber and I want to support her in her dream. And so her name is Fox. She goes by Fox or Stormy Jr. I go by Stormy_Ray on YouTube.
Hmm.
So we're looking at doing that. That's maybe something I can do to help other people out with my life's experiences. I've had tons. I've got lots of knowledge from everything I've been through, some wisdom. And especially for teenagers, even if I could just put messages out there for teenagers so that they know somebody does care. It's me. And if they need to talk to me or email me, you know, I want them to know that somebody loves them. Even if they don't know who I am, I do care. And I believe in every single person out there. I do. And I especially believe kids and teenagers need that in their lives right now. And they need some sort of art outlet and things like that with the way the world's going. And so, you know, that's kind of what we're planning on doing is just,
well, cool.
I know Bella wants to game, but I think maybe I'll get on and maybe try to help find some missing people and do some kind of thing like what you do. Not like you do, because I can't. You're so amazing with the graphics and everything.
Well, it'd be just, yeah. Well, cool.
But,
yeah.
You know, that's like, you know. Heck, and if it gives my daughter a career for her life, then wonderful. I'll be so happy for her. But if I can help somebody just by starting a YouTube channel and even just sharing my stories or other people's stories, just to help other people feel not so alone out there. I know a lot of people probably feel alone out there right now with COVID and everything, and they don't have people to reach out to. I've lost my entire family to COVID. It's just me and my daughter now. So I know I'm not the only one out there. There's other people out there too, and they need to know that somebody does care and somebody is there that is worried and praying for them and does care. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah. Yeah.
So that's kind of, you know, creative outlets and just trying to brainstorm and think of how to put things together.
Yeah, well, give it a whirl, see what happens. But
I sure will.
I hope you get it all figured out, what's going on, and, you know, keep us updated. All right.
Oh, I will. I've called you a couple times this year already. You know, I'm not going to leave you alone, right?
Yeah.
I'm going to keep pestering you.
All right.
All right.
Well, thanks for calling.
Thank you all for letting me call in.
Okay. Have a good one. All right. See you. Bye.
You too, Griffin. Bye.
I think that was it Stormy Ray, maybe? I think she said that. I've seen, she's in the chat sometimes. Let's see. Yeah, well, the lines are open, everybody. Oh, here we go. 847. You can unmute yourself. I guess it's start. Yeah. Hello?
How you doing?
Oh, it's Kubitschek. Okay, good. Now they can hear you.
Oh, good. Yeah. So I was wondering if you want to take a look at this recent case. It's of a missing gal. Her name is Amelia Brooks. She's 22. It's out of Montana.
Is this new?
Yeah, she's been missing since, I think, like mid-October.
Yeah. How do you spell her name? A-M-E-L-I-A?
Yeah, just like Earhart. And then her middle name is
Yeah, but that's assuming I know how to spell Gearhart's first name.
Amelia Earhart, okay.
A-M-E. I know how to spell. I found it already. I've already found a damn thing, okay?
That's Brooks with two O's. No, just kidding. So I don't know anything about it. I just thought we could look into it together while we're all on here.
Yeah. That says missing endangered person. Woman last seen weeks ago in Billings. Endangered person advisory, blah, blah, blah. Amelia Brooks remains missing according to the alert. She is described in the alert as someone who has mental health issues and who has been known to use drugs. Amelia family is very worried about her, according to an informational poster. The poster also states she was last seen leaving a residential area on foot. Billings police have previously said Brooks was last seen in the 800 block of Carolina Street. She's described as 5'1 and weighing 220 pounds, so probably a bit overweight there. Brooks has blue eyes, braces, and brown hair that changes to blonde halfway down, according...
Kubitschek, never heard of her ansikte som blinker med ögonen.
Kubitschek.
Shit. Cairo.
All right. Let's see. I'm just going to go nearer where this is. This is in Billings, right? Right? You still there?
Yeah.
No, I said M-O. It should be M-T, right?
Mm-hmm.
Oh, it worked.
Billings, Montana. Right? I could be wrong.
Yeah. It says 800 block, so let me see where 700 is. Now we'll know that the other direction. Yeah. Okay, so it's right in here, right around on this street right here. So one of these homes, that's the 800 block, 900's down there a little bit.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
Yeah, but is there a lot of information on it? I mean...
I don't know. Like, I...
What made you grab this one? I mean,
somebody put her name in the chat like an hour ago.
Oh. I ate some popcorn earlier.
You feeling okay?
Well, I got this little, you know, those little pieces sometimes like stuck in your throat.
Oh, yeah, like the tickle in your throat.
Yeah.
That sucks. Try to ask Blue or Chloe to give you a little tap on the back.
Nah. I bet Chloe would try, though. She'd stick her hands in the air and try to... She has mental issues. Let's see. Brooks had no reliable leads. Where about? I mean, there's no information at all. The police department at the time...
I thought I saw something like she was with her boyfriend... Maybe that was a different article. I pulled up the same one you had.
Yeah. Let me try this. Well, that was on the 5th of November. Let me see.
Yeah, I thought it said something like her boyfriend said she just randomly took off or something sounded like really suspicious. Yeah, I don't really know too much, but.
Yeah. See, people send me stuff and then I look at them. and then I try to figure out if there's something. Sometimes I'll just bring it up because there's nobody's talking about it. But most of the time, mm-hmm. I try to have something else to. So she was 22 years old. Yeah, nothing on that link. So you had the same link open I did? Let me type in the word boyfriend.
Yeah, and then I'm trying to think. I think I just pulled up one link. I thought I saw something about, like, she was with the boyfriend, and when they questioned the boyfriend, he said that she just decided to randomly take off, but he didn't have anything to say beyond that.
Well, the word boyfriend isn't in this article. So it must have been somewhere else.
I don't know. Yeah.
Crazy.
I don't know.
Thanks. Thanks, Kubi. Boy.
Sure. I tried, you know. I'm like pulling teeth here.
That was like pulling teeth. Let me see. Let me see what this one says here. Crap, man. Pop-ups. Amelia 22 subscribed, you know, white, blah, blah, blah. Police say Amelia has mental issues. Previous coverage. She's wearing tan and wool jacket, yoga pants. Billings police say detectives have no actionable leads. So there you go. They have nothing.
They have nothing. That is never good. Well.
Yeah. I wonder if she
brought a jacket and she's okay.
I mean, she probably, you know. If they said they have no actionable leads, that means they've checked her cell phone and everything. There's nothing, you know.
Yeah.
Because a cell phone, if she just called somebody right before that, then obviously they'd have a lead that was pretty significant. But they're saying they have no actionable leads. But we all know this for sure, is people just don't disappear. Right?
Yeah. So like when the cops say, oh, it sounds like they just ran off. No.
Or, well, people just don't disappear, though. I mean, like, literally, like, they walk down the street, and they just vanished. You know? Well, that didn't happen. So now let's figure out what did happen. Because we know that a UFO didn't come down and beam them up onto their ship, and they disappeared. They did, they did actually go somewhere. Something happened to them, right? So.
Yeah.
Now, it is like, possible, though.
That one boy... Mm-hmm. Like that one guy who parked at the cul-de-sac and he had something like carrying under his arm and then he just disappeared. What's his name? I always freaking forget it.
Oh, I just remembered it last week.
Why can I never remember his name? Michael? No.
Yeah, that could be. Almost
anyway,
right.
But that was weird. But I think that people took him because there was like a van chasing him after.
I think he was in Utah, right?
Yeah, something like that. He parked his car. Then the house footage shows a van following him after, like fast.
Yeah, Stephen Crozier. Stephen Crozier, or Kosher. Yeah, not Crozier.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, sounds like you got another call.
Yeah, you sound like Cairo. You just can't wait for that beep.
Just in case you didn't know what that noise was.
Yeah, thanks. All right, well, thanks for calling in. I'll go get that one.
Sure.
All right.
All right, talk to you
later. Have a good one. QB. All right, see you. All right, 406. You're on. Unmute yourself with a *6. Hello, 406. Hello? Hello? Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah, who's this?
Can you hear me?
Yeah, you got it.
Okay, this is Tanya Rome.
Uh-huh, yeah.
And I put the case out there on Amelia Brooks. I live in Billings.
Okay.
And have been following the case and of course, love your channel and everything. And I just wanted to provide a little more detail.
Okay, good. There you go.
Surrounding her disappearance. Apparently, on October 13th, she and her boyfriend were at the house on Caroline Street. And they had they had kind of a bumpy up and down, obviously, relationship and whatnot.
Do you know what house it was on here? Was, since you're from there, you know it's one of these? I'm looking around.
Like. Yeah, I don't know the actual house number.
Uh-huh.
But what the interesting part of it is he said that they went outside to have a cigarette, and it was like 4 or so in the afternoon, and she asked him to go in and get a lighter, and he came out and gave that to her, and then she said, can you go grab my coat, because I'm cold, so we went in and grabbed that and came out, and then he said she was just gone, and he, you know, went up and down the block looking for her, and she just vanished. She's just gone, and his story has kind of changed here and there a lot, and I mean, obviously, she does have a little bit of a troubled past. You can kind of tell with, you know, some of the things that are happening around her, but the interesting part is, too, is that all of the neighbors on both the back side of the house and the front of up and down the street saw nothing of her. There's nothing.
Yeah, so the whole story about going out to smoke a cigarette and everything could just be totally bogus.
Right, right. Yeah. And so it's been, I think, 31 days now since she's gone missing. And his story, I sent you some more links to your email about the Facebook group that's on Facebook, Where's Amelia Brooks, and then her boyfriend's Facebook. And he is very, very inconsistent in his stories. And apparently she didn't take her phone, any of that stuff, you know, all of that business where, oh, nope, we have it all. And then took him a while to find the phone for the, you know, and all this kind of thing. And just kind of obviously troubling. And so the family, because he was saying, oh, she's suicidal. She just ran off and that was it. And I could never find her. And so people have been searching in search groups and whatnot from the community. And obviously the police have taken all of the various communication devices and whatnot. But then they just today they got enough acquired enough money to hire a K-9 PI team that does scent and all of that kind of thing. So that lady just arrived 2 days ago to Billings, and she is searching today. It was her first afternoon with the dogs searching. And they did post a little snippet of the video of her searching, but not exactly where.
Mm-hmm.
But the dogs did get scent from Amelia 100% from where she was last, which I'm assuming was the house. And then apparently they somehow, and I don't know exactly how canine dogs work and whatnot, but now they're searching in fields and marshes.
How
and
long does it last,
like
though? How long does the scent last? Hey, you in there, Susanna? Like, I mean, like,
yeah,
you know, it's been weeks later.
You know, I was going to, what's interesting is this Karen, I'll have to give you her name. You can see it on the Amelia Brooks page. People were asking that, you know, how long are these things valid for? And she said that their record case with the FBI was 11 months.
Wow.
That the dogs, and it's confirmed, and it's on her website. I can't pronounce her last name, but it's Karen. And so she said this, the lady that's the search lady, she said 4 weeks is not a problem. We should be able to catch all the scent and do all of that. So she seems pretty reputable, and obviously she has a
good website. Did it track down the street at all from the house, or just in the house?
You know, they didn't say that, and they actually never 100% said where Amelia was. They said, we think that this is where she was, and she definitely got the scent there, and like obviously at her mom's house, Amelia's scent would be there, that kind of thing. So they did confirm that. But yeah, it's just a little suspect. And I think the reason it's not getting as, you know, much press is because the suicide thing is thrown in there, of course, and the troublesome, you know, past of this young lady. So I'm, you know, but a month gone and nobody sees her. And the boyfriend, if you go to his Facebook, he is all over the place. I mean, he is just, I can't believe the stuff that he's let out there and left out there.
Well, why don't you send me an email with like a link to that?
Yeah,
and stuff like that.
I did. Yep, I did. I sent you
when?
Just tonight. I sent
just
you an email
tonight?
That has two Facebook groups.
Okay.
But yeah, it's definitely suspect.
Well, how about send me his page too, though? Or did you do
that? Yep, I did. Yep.
Okay. All
right. Yeah, I did. I sent both the Facebook group of Where's Amelia Brooks and then this Danny Worley's Facebook page also. So anyway, I just wanted to throw that out there for you because it's been a month and she, you know, obviously doesn't sound like good news, and she doesn't drive, so she was on foot. So it's not like she took off in a car or anything either. And then just the boyfriend saying she's just vanished from the block in maybe a minute it took to get the coat. You know what I mean? Like, it's just kind of weird.
Yeah.
So I don't know. Anyway, I just wanted to call in and say that, and kind of, I'm going to keep following it up here, of course, and whatnot, but just was very interesting. I just wanted to add a little more color around everything for that.
Well, I appreciate it. Yeah, that was that did add some. But at least Kubi got it started, though, and you came in.
Yeah. Because I put that in there, and she even said, she goes, oh, that Tanya Rome, that sounds like a good one. And I said, yeah, and I was like, oh, I'm too shy to call in, but I thought, I'm going to do it.
Yeah, so. Why not? It was easy, right? I wasn't that bad, right?
Yeah. No, yeah, you're awesome.
They always say I'm so mean. You know?
No, you're just factual and practical, and I think a lot of people have a issue with that.
Yeah, aversion. I like that. Practical. That's the term. I think that's it.
Yeah. So, cool. Well, anyway, thanks for taking my call, and I'll keep watching you, and I'll let you guys know if there's anything else that transpires as well. So.
Okay. Well, hey, I appreciate you calling in. I'll check those links out, and maybe we can do it again. All right.
Great.
Okay.
Sounds good. Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye. Bye.
How much, what's the betting odds of this right here being a troll right here? What do you guys think? Don't you think the odds are like 90%? Here we go. I'm going to do the... Okay, Bob. What's going on, Bob? How's it going? I can't hear you. What's going on? Oh, lost you. I know, I lost that guy. I could barely hear it. It was like, oh well, missed it. Maybe next time. No, I didn't really lose it. It's just, if you're going to say your name is Bob, I'm not going to do the call, okay? That's how it's going to work. Usually people that call in with actual phone numbers have a better chance of being legit. It's the ones that put a name in. They're not. So... so quiet.
From the green forests of the Pacific Northwest, I bid you all good evening, or good morning as the case may be. From the green forests of the Pacific Northwest, I bid you all good evening, or good morning, as the case may be. Back to you, Jim! This is PIR, Portland International Raceway. For the biggest thing since the Pinewood Drag, we have Rod Labor, a retired astronaut with his hydroelectric car. It's guaranteed to rip up the road right in front of your face. We also have Jim Hansen with his Beavermobile, the only car that knocks down trees at 200 miles an hour. Trials from 6 and 7 be there. Oh, and don't forget the
And don't miss Jim's 32 Funny Cars. With a dog equipped with a hang glider. Oh, look at that! It's Sabrina! How's the baby doing? Did you name it Gray? Come on! Yee-hoo! Oh, it's Santiago. Wow. Yeah, we were actually talking about you a couple weeks ago, Sabrina. Sabrina Rodriguez! You're going to have to call in a minute and tell us how the hell that, what's going on.
I've been gone so long, but I'm a few weeks from giving birth to baby freak Santiago. Just wanted to donate and say goodnight. I love you great.
Okay, well, you got to call in the next couple nights, Sabrina Rodriguez. Okay, because we want to hear about this baby here. And specifically, why he wasn't named Gris. Just kidding. I think we all know the answer to that question. Yeah, well, I didn't want my son named after something that you stick inside of an engine. Okay. 904. Give it a whirl. Hello? Hello, who's this? Yep. Who's Brian? Oh, Brian. Brian who? You in the chats?
Brian Clam. My name is Brian Clam, okay?
Okay, Brian, like a frying pan? Okay, like Brian Pan, frying pan. Okay, I get it. Okay.
You can call me Brian.
Okay, I can call you Brian now. Okay, what's going on, Brian?
I got a quick question for you.
Okay, what's that? Yeah?
And the guy said they had a news conference.
Yep.
I think it was a year or two after the murders.
Uh-huh.
And they had the sheriff, they put the sheriff Lesenby. On the...
Toby Lesenby.
Well, I don't know what his name is, but I know he's the sheriff.
Well, that's who
and
the sheriff
they
is.
They asked him, is the company or is the society still at odds or is society still...
Should they still be nervous about it? And he said, oh, no, go on and live your life normally, yeah.
He said no. So how could he say that, knowing that there was a killer on the loose?
Yeah, I think most people thought that was ludicrous. And even the other guy, Kim Riley, who was standing next to him, said, I think people need to be vigilant. But he said, oh, yeah, we don't think there's any reason to be concerned. You know, I mean, I think everybody who heard him say that thought it was one of the dumbest things you've ever heard in your life, because you have a person who just killed two girls. You don't have a clue who he is, and yet everybody should... It wasn't. See, here's the thing, is when it's a targeted killing, like, you know, let's say it's a drug dealer in a town, and he ends up being killed, you can kind of say, we don't feel like the public's at risk because there was a total motive and an actual, you know, you can see that that was just a targeted killing, where this one is totally random and there's a killer out on the loose, right? So everyone thought...
How do we know that was actually totally... How do we know that one wasn't how they a know motive or something behind that?
Yeah, I don't know. I mean... That they haven't had any evidence. They in the podcast that I did and another podcast, he said that there was no evidence, and Becky said it, and Abby's mom, Anna, she said that there was no evidence that social media played a role of any kind. Unless, okay. Now, if you think it was a drug thing, like there's all these rumors out there about... Derek and stuff like that, and somebody was trying to pay him back and this kind of thing, and you know, I've heard those rumors. There's nothing to substantiate it at all. This guy just seems like a, you know, whether it was his first time or what, but like a serial killer type. You know, he's just there was even signatures, that kind of thing.
Now, one of the girls, I think it may be Libby, she got him on a cell phone. on the bridge, some guy. How do we know that that's the actual killer and not just some random person she got on her cell phone?
Because they know it is. It's the timing of it. Don't you think that's kind of obvious? Like, you see this guy on the video, and then he says, "Hey, guys, get down the hill," and then that's it, and then they end up dying right after that. I think it's really obvious. Yeah, it was Libby's phone.
You think she would have called maybe her family after she saw a suspicious guy kind of following them, or?
Yeah, I mean, you know, a lot of people say, why didn't they do this? Why didn't they do that? I think she was just filming her. Like, I mean, filming the guy. You know, he probably came up on him sort of quickly. Like, they probably saw him, but then didn't know if he was going to keep going. And then he came upon him, and maybe she turned on her camera to film because she wasn't really quite sure, you know, but they were a little bit nervous about this guy. And, it, you know, then it ends up turning out to be the worst case scenario. And then at that point, she didn't have time to call. But before that, she wasn't thinking, oh, I better call my mom, you know, didn't want to look like, get too panicky over something that might be nothing, right? I think people picture things after the fact. The Monday morning quarterbacking on the Delphi case is probably one of the more disturbing aspects of it. Why didn't they run? Why didn't they do this? Why did the parents let them go out there? Why did they, you know, who the hell gives a shit, okay? The truth is they got killed by a freaking monster. And we just need to find out who that person is. The whys on those other things are absolutely meaningless to the case. Why didn't they run? Meaningless. Okay? They didn't know the person. If they knew the person, they would have said, "Hey, Jim, how's it going?" You know? They didn't do that.
Yeah.
Right. So.
So there's a new YouTuber that I ran across. I don't remember her name, but she's a new YouTuber, and she did the press conference, and she did the body language of the sheriff or the cop.
It's a pile of shit video. Just letting you know right off the bat. Okay, as soon as people start doing that, like they pretend that their body language. Oh yeah, look at that. Look at the sheriff. Let me guess. They're claiming that the sheriff had something to do with it, right?
Well, that's kind of what they were hinting, yeah. And I think some people in the comments actually felt that it's somebody in law enforcement that they're covering up for, and that's why it hasn't been solved.
Right. Well, let me ask you this. The FBI was there for months, and they still have a presence. Do you think they're part of it, too? Or would they be covering up for a sheriff? See, that some of these people don't think through the shit that they put out there. They do it to get views, and guess what? You watched it. They got a view from you because, you know, it seemed interesting and neato, and they're just full of crap. And then I know where you were going. You were saying that that this person claimed that, you know, based on body language and whatnot, it was probably the sheriff. But then earlier you were talking about the sheriff and saying that he said that they have nothing to worry about, the population. Well, he's the one that would know that they had nothing to worry about because his job was done, right? That's kind of what you were hinting at, right?
Well, that's kind of the first thing I thought when you said that. I was like, maybe he's the killer.
Well, but, but he's not.
That's kind of what my mind said. Yeah.
I think here's what the reality is. Toby Lesenby isn't really a genius of any kind. He's just, out of all the people working on the case, he's the one that I just go, oh, Jesus. He lets stuff slip often. He says things that aren't really reasonable. They're just sort of like, oh, Jesus. He's one of those guys that just sort of became a sheriff. You know, I don't know how that all worked, but, you know, the other investigators have been working really hard on it. All of them, you know? I mean, the FBI, like, I can tell you, like, Jerry Holman, Riley, all of them, they've just been working their asses off. And the FBI was in there, gave them all their resources, even had them come in there. And there's no way in hell they aren't checking into that stuff. And I don't think anybody would cover up for anybody. Now, is it possible that the killer is in law enforcement? Sure. Okay, I mean, it is possible. But I don't think that anybody knows that and are covering it up if that is true, okay? That's what I'm saying, is like, I guarantee it they wouldn't do that. They would be more than happy to arrest one of their police officers to solve this case, okay? You know, but when you say, is it possible? Sure, something's always possible.
So do you feel that it will be solved in the coming years?
I think so. I mean, I feel like it's going to be solved, but I mean, it's more me
prince,
wanting it to be solved.
Family, you guys are so sweet. I'll call next time to let you guys know how I am.
I'm very healthy, happy.
Happy, awaiting the arrival of my first child.
Oh, you haven't had your baby yet?
Maybe next boy will be great.
Yeah. Nice. Okay. I thought you already had your baby, so it must be almost due, Sabrina. Okay. So anyways, what are you thinking about this case then?
Well, I'm still kind of puzzled about the case. That's why I look at different people's videos.
Well, everybody's puzzled about it. There isn't a soul out. Listen, I don't know what to tell you. I don't want to be like, but there is so many garbage videos out there. And I'd love to just sit here and rattle off all the ones that put out the pile of shit videos, especially the one that came out recently pretending that they took the, listen how stupid this is. They took the audio file of, hey guys, get down the hill. They took that and they say that the FBI put in a sort of a filter thing on there to hide what was said in between. And then he reversed that out. Just think about how stupid that is. And then all of a sudden he starts hearing stuff like sheriff and these other words pop in there. You don't think that when they played that without the filter, they would have went, oh, look at that. One of the girls said sheriff. And look at one of the girls said this. One of the girls. So what he's claiming now is that he took off the filter and then he got that from the remaining part. It's one of the, you know what he's doing to all you guys? He's tricking you with the EVP bullshit. It's the same thing. And as a matter of fact, it's like AUP or, you know, some other term. And then he puts comments in there all the time. Don't let anybody come in here and say something, you know, right, because he wants you to believe him. He doesn't hear a damn thing. None of that stuff. And the only videos that are realistic are the ones that literally show you plausible things that are going on with the actual image, not 57 filters put on there, zooming in a zit on the nose, when the zit is 1/8 of the size of a pixel that was on the original video. Okay, it's stupid. Like the guy, oh, look at, there's blood. I can see it now. What's this one for? Well, no, what that was one of the images was reversed and a filter put on it. Oh, okay. All right. Well, what about this? Well, no, because now you already said that first one. That was inaccurate. So now we just can't really trust anything else that you put out there. Yeah, I just really frustrated. I'm going to tell you this. If you just want sort of a general reality of what's going on, go watch my videos. Okay? If you want a bunch of sensationalistic bullshit where a lot of effort was put in there to sell a narrative that they want you to do so they can, you know, get views on their channel, go watch those. But if you want to actually have the factual information, you can go check out all my... I've made like 50 videos, 12 of them were debunking videos. So there you go.
Yeah, some of yours are actually pretty long to get through, though.
Well, there was a bunch of videos early on. Yeah. Well, the thing is because we actually sit through and talk about stuff. You know, the other ones just make these little short videos to sell a story. Yeah, I mean, I did live shows, but if you go back and watch all the debunking videos, it'll give you an idea of the type of crap that people say and do, and realize that you got to be really discerning what you're looking at instead of just everything's great, you know. Yeah, they are long. I do a live show, you know, that's what it is.
Well, so, I just wanted to get your take on that weird statement, and if you thought that
I always thought it was a weird statement,
law enforcement was involved. And
yeah, there's another guy in the press conferences that I see, and there's one guy that I've mentioned to other people that I always thought, God, that guy looks weird, you know. But it doesn't mean anything because that's just my thought. So I don't ever talk about it in public, you know. It's that's the difference between me and other people. They just bring up anything they want and get people all excited, and it's totally irresponsible. 100% irresponsible. So, anyways, well, I appreciate you calling in. I would bet a tremendous amount of money that Toby Lesenby is not the killer on the bridge.
Or connected to the killer in any way.
Well, I mean, you know, now you've changed it up a little bit. You know, the whole thing is there's one killer on the bridge. I don't think it's him. Okay?
Okay.
That's my assessment. So, anyways, thanks for calling in, man. Appreciate it.
Thanks for taking my call. Have a good night.
You too. Bye. Well, you don't really know what the response was, Susanna, because the girl that was talking didn't really remember that well either what was said, so you'll just need to wait until we get that information. Right, Sabrina Rodriguez. So when is the baby, what did she say? Can you guys type it in? When's the baby due? Santiago with a goal! Oh, December 14th. Oh, 1 month from today. Sweet. We'll have to see if there's some baby freak gear out there. You can put like a little tiny freak t-shirt on it, on Santiago. Yeah, it turned out okay. That wasn't the one that had Bob on it. Yeah. Freak onesie. Let me see what they have on Teespring over here. Oh, jeez. Tired. Long day. Yeah, see, these are all the different things now. Oh, look at... Wait, no, that's a pet. Would that fit, though? Look! It's for a little tiny dog. Man, I need to get one of those. That would work, though. Look at that. Little tiny... Huh. Yeah, it doesn't really look like... I don't think they have any onesies. Yeah, nope. With Freak on it, Sarah Beth? That'd be cool. I don't know what that means. Trying to figure out how they would work. I don't get it. I need a full sentence. That'd be cool. Well, what do you need from me in terms? Do you need like the design for the... Well, the pet one would work great. You just cut off the bottom legs and just put the arms through the other part. And actually, most of the time, they only have two legs, two armholes, and because the rest of it's just sort of a coat thing that rests on the back. It would work easily. Yeah. Well, you wouldn't want, even if it looked great, you wouldn't want to say, well, where'd you get that? Well, it's actually for a dog. Oh my God, you're treating your child, your new baby, like a dog. Right? Yeah, it's got like a, it's like a coat on the back, kind of. Yeah, maybe you put it on backwards. I don't know. Sure, all kinds of. Well, I think that's going to be it for me, you guys. That's been a long day on here. Sorry for the one troll that got one of his lines in. And he knew that other person was a troll. Hey, unmute that one! And unmute that one caller! Right, right. Yeah, and you're not a troll now? Jesus. Yeah, well, it's more like a Aussie... in Australia, they have those Outback jackets that you put on. It's a little bit like that. You know, I can't remember what they're called, but I have one in the closet over here. I still have one from when I was there. They put this oil stuff on them, and the water just flies right off. And they have these little shoulder pads on them and everything. Yeah, maybe something like that. Here, let me see if I can find mine. Oh, Jesus. Yeah, look, see? Look at that. It's got the little shoulder thing on it. It's called a, this is from like 1980. Let's see, Driza Bones. Oh, Driza Bone it's called. Is there still a company called that? It's called Driza Bone. That's kind of funny though. D-R-I-Z-A and then Bone. Yeah. Now these are awesome though. They're long, it's like a long jacket. So, anyways, I'm going to put it back in there.
Ooh. Hey, Nita Damani.
Oh, that's what you meant? Oh, cool. Dry as a bone. That's the one that I have. It's old. I've had that for 40 years, if you can believe that. Or 39, I guess. I don't even know if it fits anymore. Yeah, they're pretty good because when the rain hits it, it just flies off. I don't know, Honey Hush. I did a whole show earlier for 2 hours. Now I got this one going on. This one's been going on for 2 hours and 13 minutes. How about another 17 minutes? Oh, cool. Awesome. Maybe you know what you're going to have to do, Sabrina? Well, come on a Zoom call, which I use anyways, but you can come on the video version and let us all see Santiago. Okay? How does that sound? Yeah, that'd be sweet. Little baby freak coming into the world. Santiago Super Freak Rodriguez. Or actually, Santiago Baby Freak Rodriguez. There we go. It's coming, everybody. Hey, Mary Lou, you got to work on that tone a little bit, right? That's scary sounding with that tone. You see that? You hear that one? Christmas is coming, everybody.
Hickory dickory dock. Yeah, I can't do that one, Billy Boy Blue. Can't do that one.
You know, I'm kind of looking forward. I like doing Christmas in here. You know, it's fun. It's just even on like Christmas Eve or whatever. You know, just kind of doing a show with sort of a Christmassy background. Little music playing. It's pretty cool. With the freaks.
Hickory,
thank you, Steph May.
No, we can't do that one.
Oh, yeah, and earlier, I think I forgot to mention Mag. Thank you, Mag. I don't know if you're still out there, Mag, but I don't know if a caller was on at the time, but Steph May and Billy Bully Blue. How's the train business going out there? Kind of like this one. Oh, you just got off one? Oh, I did two shows today. Almost sounds like a mix between like some sort of a Yiddish song and something else. Now it's too much. Too much now. Yes. Baby Santiago. Oh, yeah? Let's see. Yeah, you should call in the next show, Dennis. That'd be cool. Maybe tomorrow we'll do another one if you want. Have they identified anybody in that case yet, Dennis? Any identification made? Are they stuck at this point? Oh, okay. That wasn't really that scary, Gene. It was interesting. See, that's one of the ones for the Hey, some of these are used for the Oh yeah. That's the one right there. That's the one where I got to do my funny advertisement thing. Here we go. Watch. Yeah.
This is PIR, Portland International Raceway. We're the biggest thing since the Pinewood Drag. We have Rod Labor with his retired astronaut. In his hydroelectric car, it's guaranteed to rip up the road right in front of your face. We also have Jim Hansen with his Beaver Mobile. It's the only car that knocks down trees at 200 miles an hour. Trials from 6 and 7 be there.
Yes. Well, I mean, you know, just in a short thing, he'll talk about it in detail, but it's just sort of like his name is a name, a last name, that turns up to be one of the, you know, cases he's interested in. And they were like, wow, well, we better check this out. But who knows? Ding, ding, ding. Well, it's a beaver mobile, not beaver. See, because it's a Jim Hansen with his beaver mobile. It's the only car that cuts down trees at 200 miles an hour. You get it? And then Rod Laber, a retired astronaut, with his hydroelectric car. It's guaranteed to rip up the road right in front of your face. You know what's weird? Somebody taught me this whole thing because it was funny when I was about 8. And I still remember that. It's crazy. Yeah, okay, now you're going to say, yeah, the Schnee Overholzer kid. Scary times. Deep in the cesspools of humanity, people come together to discuss the horrors of humanity itself. Even somebody by the name of Zozo will talk about true crime and the depravity of mankind. Can you believe that? Yeah, who knows if they actually got DNA from the killer. They have DNA, they just didn't know who's who and what.
Collected DNA from Killer Delphi believes someday they will catch him. Just random thought.
Yep, hope so. Maybe they'll develop better techniques in the next 5 years. Because it really went huge jumps from 2012 to 2016, and then even a way bigger one into 2018. And I can imagine it's even better now than it was then. Thank you, Sabrina Rodriguez. That over here.
What are you and you doing? Oh. I didn't know that. That. Oh my god, oh my god, what the hell is going on? What the hell? Who's going on?
All right, everybody. I just got to get out of here. I don't have any more to talk about. You know, just staring at the chat. Everybody's like doing goofy stuff unrelated to anything. So, anyways, I am going to get the hell out of here. Sabrina, make sure you check in with us before your birth and then after, too. You know, just let us know. Okay, going in. You know? All right, cool. So, anyways, thank you guys for showing up here. Let me switch over to the...
Okay. Thank you, Juju Positive. Sarah Beth Coolagrass. In the Middle of Nowhere Bear, Kevin Brown. In the Middle of Nowhere Bear, Kevin Brown. In the Middle of Nowhere Bear, Hilly Boy Blue, Cairo. Christy B, Kevin Brown, Cairo, Tanya Rome, Claudia Neubauer. Kuba Check, Shogun Love, good to see you, Shogun, Mary Clark, and Mag, thank you, VP, Billy Boy Blue, what the hell happened, Cairo, Jen H, Cairo, FB, Sabrina Rodriguez, and Santiago, Sabrina Rodriguez again, Steph May, Billy Boy Blue, Sabrina Rodriguez, and Dadio Caspian Horses Rock. Yes.
All right, everybody. So make sure that you wear your mask, maintain your social distancing, and do the, washing your hands all the time. Okay? But as soon as you get your vaccine in you and you wait the 28 days, lick mud off your fingers. If that's all, for all I care. I don't care. I, literally walk around in crowds and breathe in deeply. And then lick your fingers and hug as many people as you can, okay? But until you get that vaccine, wear your mask, maintain your social distancing, and wash your hands, okay? I've been saying that since the very beginning. I bet you could trace my comments before Fauci, okay? Okay, awesome. Yes, get the vaccine first, and then you can do all those things that I was just talking about. All right, everybody, thank you very much for showing up tonight and the other show earlier today about a couple of recent cases. And that's it. But I'll let you guys can sit around and chat for a while, okay? That's right. Gray Hughes Investigates. Best on YouTube. Daddy-O Caspian Horses Rock. Yeah, I've been doing this true crime thing for quite a while now. And during this whole time, I have not seen one person that is a...
crime detector, paradactyl.
I'm a
certified human lie detector. Gonna get you.
If you try and play me like an old projector, crime sector is my nectar.
Professor Grimm is gonna give another lecture.
Crime collector, freak connector, and I'm always gonna be a bug detector.
Fool reflector,
interceptor. Gonna meet a little specter with a vector.
On his specter,
with all respect, ya.
Just remember,
I have a temple fucking check.
I have no agenda.
I'm a pretender.
And I'll give it to you straight without a blender.
And in the end,
I'm gonna send you
on a mission to
the field of vendor. Hey, you boy.
Yeah, so I'll just get right back to work. All right, everybody? Talk to you.
Okay, well, that was really cool. That was really neat, all the songs with all the people, the trolls that called in and the cool people that called in. You remember that one?
Oh, my God. Here you go again. You sound like an auctioneer. You sound exactly like one.
I'm tired of it, not 10 down,
15,
Hey, wait, that's different than you normally do. You're just supposed to say goodnight to me.
Oh, okay. Good night, Mary Lou.
Good night, John Boy G.
Wait, why are you crying this time?
Oh, yeah, you didn't really say anything. Okay.
I don't like you anymore, Mary Lou.
Okay, cuss, John Boy. That's so mean.
Yeah, that's much better.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah, wow. Yeah, now they seem like they're almost trolling me a little bit, but that's okay. All right, everybody. Thank you for showing up tonight. And as I always say, everybody, be safe out there. And a 2, and a 3. And a 4, and a 5. And you guys can chat for a while, too. Feel free. You know, do all the conversation over and over again. The Billy Boy, Blue, and Kubitschek saga.
Good night, Wally Gator.
What happened, Tracy? What happened? What's going on?